So now we're in Castilla y León in Spain with Microbio, and I love this project. I have a couple lines from him in this month and hope to have more. And this one is incredibly unique. This is a grape that I would be absolutely shocked if you've had it, unless it was a mix in a port wine that you've had before and wouldn't have known. So it's Rufete, which is a Northern Portuguese and or Northern Spanish, I think it originated in Portugal, grape that they typically use in the Douro region in Portugal and put in port. So you're not typically seeing it in still red, or not still, but non-dessert, I guess, red wines. But Ishmael decided to do a still dry red version of it and put it in just regular Burgundy bottles. Let me see if I know. Just Burgundy barrels and age it for 9 to 10 months. So completely different take, as if you've already had it. I guess, assume you have because you've had port, but completely different take on that. So a very exciting, like when I read about this wine with his line, because I tried to bring in a couple of, or I think I brought in like 8 of his wines this month. And this one I just thought was the most interesting of all the ones that he'd had, especially on the red side, because I know this is going in our red club. Because you're not going to find this anywhere else. So hopefully that gives you an idea of generally what to expect, or just confuse you completely, because I didn't really know exactly what I thought this would taste like, but I just thought, I've also been very into port lately since we went to Portugal. I just thought it would be very cool, if nothing else. Luckily though, it's very delicious. All right. So this is, let's see on this. This is a 2017. So it does have some age on it. Plus it spent those, about 10 months in Burgundy barrels, which means that it's got some lovely, both, I guess, a little bit of oxidation because it's been in those barrels, as well as exposure to old Burgundy barrels. So what could go wrong there? We all know we like Burgundy, or I like Burgundy. Hopefully you do too. All right. So it's not as dark as I was expecting, actually. I expected it to be quite dark, and it's, fairly garnety in color, I would say. It's starting to get some room variation just because it's 2017. And it's quite aromatic. I can smell it from here. And it just smells lovely. It smells like dark and broody, I guess. But also very refined. I feel like that's an important note to this. Some wines are just like dark and deep and dark and broody. This one's like deep and refined. All right. So on the top, I'm getting quite fruity, still very fruity for the amount of age that it has. But before I get into that, I would say it's got really lovely baking spices. I don't know exactly which ones, if it's like maybe like, it's definitely got like some cinnamon notes to it, maybe some cardamom, clove, all the stuff that kind of reminds me of Christmas. And I love drinking port at Christmas too, so maybe that's the other reason I picked this one for this month. It's funny, I pick these wines, and then when I'm actually talking about them on the videos, I realize why I was probably interested in them. So you guys get to learn that at the same time that I do. So it would make a lot of sense that I would be interested in a port grape wine at Christmas, because I just think that that's a really nice time to have them. It's honestly a little bit, it's interesting because it's got fresh fruit, but I'd also say it's a little bit pruney. And maybe I'm just feeling that because of the whole, it's a port grape thing, but I could see that. And then the cherries, I would say it's like kind of like dried cherries or smoked cherries or something. There's a quality to the cherries that's not quite as fresh. But I wouldn't really call it jammy. We'll see how it feels on the palate, but you could say it's kind of jammy, but I would say it's more dry than jammy. All right, let's try it. Wow, it develops so much in your mouth. So it starts, let me just remember the end because I might forget. It like has this like licorice style finish to it that I wasn't getting anywhere else. It like starts with like the spices. It starts with like the, kind of like what did I say, like dried cherries or smoked cherries or whatever. It's got that. It's got the like baking spices in it. But then it's, man, this is like the most Christmassy red wine ever. And then it just kind of goes into this like licorice-y, maybe even like a little bit minty. Hang on, let's try it again and see. Because if it has mint in it, then like that's like almost like a little candy cane at the end. And then we're really in the Christmas zone. I would say it's got a little bit of mint, but that might just be now because I'm hoping that it's there. But if you get it too, you let me know. But I mean, like, it's got all those spices in it, so it would make sense that you might find some mint in there as well alongside some of those other ones. And like, I don't even think I said like not oregano, but what's the other one, tarragon. Like you could definitely pick those up from there as well. So it's incredibly complex. Like, holy crap, this guy did amazing job of like really letting this wine express itself. And then I'm sure putting it in those Burgundy barrels also brought some different nuances out that we wouldn't have gotten otherwise. It's just beautiful. So you don't actually, oh, and I didn't even talk about, there's too much to talk about. The tannin is, I would say, like medium plus or whatever. It's not high, but I would also say that it's just a little bit more than like you're like, it's not mellow either. The same with the acid, I would say it's probably also like medium plus, not high, but not middle of the road either. And it really, I don't know, it's just accentuating all those flavors that we saw there. So with all that in mind and thinking about pairing it, I want to put this with like lamb. I want to put it with like something with a lot of spices. But not like, I don't know, normally when I say lamb, I'm thinking like tagine, and you could, I think it would be good with it, but I'm thinking more like the Christmas version of lamb or whatever red meat you're going to have that has like Christmassy spices in it. Like what? Like, yeah, I don't know. Lamb, is it lamb shank or pork? Some sort of shank. That's like what I'm picturing, but I'm sure there's all kinds of other stuff you could do. Rib roast, as you guys know, I'm not the cook here, but I think you get where we're going with this. Would be good with a lot of different styles of meat. It also honestly would be good with different types of like winter squash. Could be great with this as well, especially if you have like, I don't think I said saffron. I don't think I've ever said a wine has saffron in it, now that I think about it. But, and now that, why did I say saffron? There was a dish, it wasn't paella. Oh, like risotto or something with saffron in it. Oh, I guess that is kind of like paella. I don't know. Something like that could also be really good here. Like regular paella that has like, not the fish version, but like the rabbit in it, could also be really nice. I don't know. It's delicious. You could put it with all kinds of stuff. But just really what I would say is think about all the lovely spices and like the depth that you have with this when you're pairing it with something, because that's really what's going to make it shine and what's going to like really pair it well with your meal. So I'm very impressed with this, very excited for this project. And yeah, if you like this one, go check out the other stuff he has. He has tons of wines. And I think we have 8 or 9 on our site right now. So enjoy.